hurricane experience and the devastation he has seen so far. Tiffany?
Karen and Abner, over the phone, we spoke to Rohit Mittal. He just left Lubbock in August to attend New York University, but he had no idea the city that never sleeps would be transformed into a city of destruction. As the death toll rises to more than 70 people, rescue crews continue searching for those trapped. Families walk around their leveled homes. Subways remain underwater, and millions are still left in the dark with no electricity. It's a scene that 19-year-old Rohit Mittal will never forget.
We saw roofs out, we saw windows broken, all these signs just floating around. And even still today, like, we went outside, there's still no, like, there's no street lights on. And it was just like every man for themselves in the streets, actually, because I just thought, like, out of my window, I'm seeing a car and two cars almost collide to each other.
Starting on Sunday, NYU sent out warnings for their students to prepare for the worst as Sandy violently hit the East Coast.
Lubbock, we have all this wind and we just have all these dust storms there. I was honestly just scared for my life. I just had my cell phone next to me and my flashlight, and it was pretty much like, I really hope this tree does not come down on my dorm.
As the city remained dark, Rohit's dorm was one of the only places left with power from a backup generator.
We've been helping the local communities. They're coming into this dorm to, like, charge their laptops, charge their cell phones, to use our bathrooms, take a shower if they want to.
It's like nothing else he has ever seen. Families losing everything, a vibrant city coming to a halt. But through the terrifying experience, Rohit counts his blessings.
I am honestly thankful to be alive right now. It's just like this feeling, I guess, I have inside of me that's like, it's good to be alive.
To get the most up-to-date information on Sandy's destruction and the aftermath, you can go to kcbd.com. Karen and Abner.